and then the temperature as well as the moisture content. Okay. So I will write the energy balance for this system here. So if you write the energy balance for overall heat exchanger, if you write the energy balance for it, you will have that. So this one will be steady. Okay. And I will assume that this one is adiabatic. And the heat exchangers do not do any work. Okay. They do not do any work on the, you can see the heat exchanger here. They don't provide any work. It's only for the heat exchanger between two fluids. So adiabatic here means that, so the heat exchange so happens only the heat exchange happens only between two fluids. Here you have the steam and here you have the cooling water. Heat exchange happens between those two fluids. There is no heat exchange with this device and the environment. Okay, and then okay, so you don't have any no heat exchange with environment. And then no work output. So this one is no work. This is another. This is not actually approximation, but this is the reality that these heat exchangers do not provide any work. Okay, so with that in mind, so I can write the energy balance. So it will be that steady case in is same as out. Since this one is an open system, you always have the enthalpy. So that mass flow rate, m dot, in for the steam, and enthalpy in for the steam. This is the inlet for the system. You can see that steam is the inlet. And as well as you have inlet for the cooling water here. So it will be that m dot of the cooling water and the enthalpy of the inlet for the cooling water. This is for the inlet case. Now, similarly for the outlet, you will have that m dot out for the steam, okay, and the enthalpy out for the steam plus m dot for the cooling water and the enthalpy cooling water. This one is also out quantity. So that in and out quantities are balanced. For inlet, we have the steam inlet and the cooling water inlet, and for the outlet, we have the steam outlet and the cooling water outlet. Okay. So then this one is steady, and therefore that m dot steam inlet and m dot steam outlet, these are the same stuff, and we can write just m dot steam and the enthalpy in steam and the enthalpy steam outlet. We will use the tables to find it. Firstly, let's start with the inlet value for the, let me look at it here. So you are having this one as the inlet for this one, which is 80.7% and the 10 kilopascal. Now let's go back to the chart here. So we have the 10 kilopascal of water and we have the quality. And that means that we are in that saturated region. For saturated region, I need the HF value and I need this HFG value. Okay. Now let me go back to this question here. So that moisture content is so that that is 18.7%, and that one is 1 minus x. And from here, x will be that 1 minus 18.7, and then you will have that 81.3%. This is the quality of the, and this one is at 10 kilopascal, quality of water. So with using this chart, I will go back to the chart again to take the values here. So you have that 101.81 and 2392.1. This one is the HFG and this one is HF, and multiplied with the X value and you will get that enthalpy value. Okay. And this one is that HF and this one is HFG. and x value is 0.813. So you can calculate the value for me and tell the value of enthalpy here. And this one is for enthalpy inlet for water. Okay. Now we'll try to find enthalpy outlet for the water. And then, now let's find it while you are calculating this one. And enthalpy at outlet, it says that, so let me go back to here. Enthalpy outlet is supplied. After passing it, it is transferred by pump as a saturated liquid state. So after passing this heat exchanger, this one, so at outlet, it is saturated liquid. And it is transferred by pump as a saturated liquid. But you should remember that for heat exchangers, so we consider that it is isobaric. Pressure doesn't drop. That is a general case for any heat exchanger for thermodynamic analysis. So the pressure drop is not considered. And since that, for this case, we will not consider the pressure drop. Okay. And therefore, you will have that at outlet since it is saturated liquid and it will be that HF. And then HF value, so H outlet for steam. And it will be equal to that HF value. And this one is 191.81 kJ/kg. And enthalpy value, that is, so is this one in kilojoules or joules? So 194. So the value is x, which is 0.813. This is the x value, and multiplied with 2392.1 and plus 191.81. So is this, okay, the result is that Ali says 6.58 kilojoules per kilogram. Okay. Madat also, okay, good. So we have found the case for the steam here. Steam inlet is okay, and the steam outlet is okay. This one is saturated liquid state, and this one is that with the quality here. And now let's try to find the values for the cooling water. It says that it comes with 20 degrees Celsius, okay, and then it goes with the 40 degrees Celsius. Okay, so that cooling water is supplied for the tower at 20 degrees Celsius, and it rises temperature to 40 degrees Celsius. Again, for this part, we will consider this one as the so 20 degrees Celsius, you will need the enthalpy value and the 40 degrees Celsius, and you will need this enthalpy value for this one. And you will consider that for this one, the pressure is 1 atm. Okay. Because that cooling water is supplied from the, so this one is cooling water. It is supplied from these cooling towers here. And these are the, that is at atmospheric pressure. Okay. We will consider it as atmospheric pressure. It can be a bit more than that one, but it is not so important. And at 1 atm pressure, so pressure is 1 atm, and the temperature is 20 degrees Celsius. So what is the state of this one? Compressed or saturated or superheated? So we can say it. So is it compressed or saturated or superheated or this? The 1 atm and the 20 degrees Celsius. Okay, so we are saying that the 1 atm and since it is from cooling towers. The cooling towers open to atmosphere. Okay. So here you are assuming 1 atm, 1 atm for this one. So is it saturated or superheated? So at 1 atm 20 degrees Celsius, it is of course that it is compressed, because 1 atm at 100 degrees Celsius is, let me add it here, and this one is at compressed state. Okay, because at 1 atm and 100 degrees Celsius, the water is at saturated region, and therefore if the temperature is less, it will be compressed state. Okay, similarly here, you will have that for the second state, you will have 1 atm and the temperature is 40 degrees Celsius, and what is the state? It will be compressed, because 100 degrees Celsius, it is saturated. Therefore, it should be compressed again. And if you remember, for the compressed states, so we were using that. So this one is the, so you should remember from previous lectures. So that for the compressed state, what we are doing is that, so you take the, okay, you are taking the F values, HF values for the compressed state, okay, or you are taking that UF value, okay, or you are taking that is new F values, okay? So because the compressed state table, this one, the table is limited. It is possible that you don't find the values that you want. But therefore, what you are doing is that you are taking HF and the UF and the new F values from the table. Okay, and you are looking for these values from the table. Now that I can move on to the table, and I will find the HF value for these temperatures. So I will first find HF value at 20 degrees Celsius, and then I will find HF value at 40 degrees Celsius. But you should know that these are compressed state. But for the compressed state, this is from the previous lectures, we were using the table of the saturated region, but with F values here. This is from the previous lecture. Now I will share the table for you, and you can see that's how we are going to find it. So first I will go to the compressed state table, and you will see that at compressed state region, you don't have enough. These are superheated, and these are superheated again, compressed. You can see that compressed region starts with 5 megapascal, 10 megapascal, and 15 megapascal, and ends at 50 megapascals. You don't have, the table is limited here. Less than 5 megapascals, we don't have the values. Therefore, for less than 5 megapascals, we have talked about this one. We are using the saturated region values, but with F subscript. I will go to the saturated region table, but for the, not for the pressure, but for the temperature, because the temperature values are given here. So for the first one, I will take the 20 degrees and the HF value here, and then I will take the 40 degrees, again the HF value here. For the 20 degrees, HF value is 83.915 kilojoules per kilogram. And at 40 degrees, you will have that 167.3 kilojoules per kilogram. That is for the compressed state zone. And now I will finish the example and solve it. Okay. So I will go back to the example here. So I have the HF value at 20 degrees and the HF value at 40 degrees Celsius. I will just replace all of the values back to my equation. And so I have also the values for the inlet, which is for the, this one is for inlet, and this one is for the outlet. Okay, my equation is this one. I will just write my equation values here. So for the enthalpy inlet for steam, you have 21, 36.3 58. And the enthalpy in for cooling water, so this one is 83.915. And the enthalpy out for the steam, this one, and this is the value was 191.81. And the cooling water outlet, and this one is also 161.53. And the question says that find the mass ratios. Okay, what is the mass ratio between these two ones? Okay, and mdot steam in and mdot steam out, these are the same ones, and you can just write this one as, this one will be mdot steam here, and this one also will be mdot steam here. And the mdot cooling water, so you will just write this one as, so for this one, you can just write mdot cooling water, same as, so okay, these are no problem. So I've just written it before, mdot cooling water. Okay, with these values, okay, what you will do is that you will find that what is the ratio of mdot steam versus mdot cooling water. What is that ratio? You will just say me the ratio, and we will finish the first part of the example. Okay. The second part of the example says that to find the heat transfer between these two fluids. And for that one, so first one, the second one is much easier than the first one, because at the first one you'll need the table values, but for the second one you will just write the energy balance here. So you should also remember that for the first case, our control volume is CV is for overall heat exchanger. Overall heat exchanger is our control volume. But in the second part, we will take a part of the control volume as our, so a part of the heat exchanger as our control volume. Okay, so let's wait for your values here. 23 point, Mahmoud Tahir says that 23.25. This is the ratio. So for this heat exchanger, for this amount of the heat ratios, you have to give this amount of mass ratio, 23.25. Now next part of the question says that how much is it transferred from one fluid to another? Let's do that one. Find it. So I will select the CV now will be, CV will be, you can select either, so that cooling water, so, or you can select, doesn't matter, that is steam. Okay, so let's select the steam for my case, but you can select any of it, it doesn't matter. Okay. So that CV for steam only. If you select the CV for steam only, because then now you will have that again, in is same as out. Okay. For that one, you will have that mass flow rate for the steam multiplied with steam inlet. Okay. And the mass flow rate for the steam and multiplied with steam outlet enthalpy. Now my question will come to you that heat transfer for the steam, is it in property or out property? So can you say me that mass flow rate for the, sorry, that heat transfer for the steam, is it into the system or out of the system? Okay, who has an idea? This one is of course out, as you have said, Q dot out, because this one is hot. But you can do the similar steps for the CV for cooling water only. Okay. If you do that one, you will have the same relationship, in is same as out, and mdot cooling water, enthalpy cooling water in, will be equal to mdot cooling water, enthalpy cooling water out. Okay. But now that, you will have the opposite of it. You will have that Q dot in. This one is cooling water, and this one is that steam. This one is steam. But at the end, you should remember that Q dot out steam as Q dot in for the clean water. You should get the same values. It doesn't matter whether it is steam or not. And the question now says us to find per unit kilogram. Okay. So per unit kilogram. So I will take the take steam, for example, but you can take any of it. It doesn't matter. If I take the steam, I will have that enthalpy steam inlet will be equal to enthalpy steam outlet and the plus this one divided by the mass flow rate. Q dot out steam divided by m dot steam. And therefore, if I replace this value as that Q out and the steam, you will have that Q out steam will be equal to enthalpy steam inlet minus enthalpy steam outlet. So for the inlet, for the steam, you have that 21, 35, 36.58, 21 and 36.58 minus, that is for the inlet, 191.81. So 191.81 kilojoules per kilogram. So if you can tell me the value of this calculation, okay, this is Ali Saif, 1944.77 kilojoules per kilogram. Okay. And this is the final result for this heat exchange. Okay. The heat exchangers, so I have talked about the heat exchanger for the, you can see that this power plant, but heat exchangers everywhere. If you remember our chart here, let me go back to the table actually, not the chart. So if you remember this table here, the devices, and you can see that most of the devices are heat exchanger. I can show you some of it. For example, that famous one is this condenser. This one is heat exchanger at your refrigerator at your home or air conditioner or in power plants. Okay. We have solved for one example for this one. Okay, or that dehumidifier, this one is also heat exchanger. Okay. It removes. So this one is actually a combination of heat and the mass exchanger because there is mass exchanger too. Economizer, it is exchanger. Evaporator, it is also heat exchanger in refrigerators and air conditioners. Or you can have that heat exchanger. So let me see, heat exchanger, this one is a general one. But the radiator at your, if there is a radiator here or no, the car radiator. Car radiator is also heat exchanger. Now, in this one, you have the heat exchange between air and the antifreeze. You have antifreeze and the air, you have the heat exchanger for the car radiator. And this antifreeze is the mixture of glycol and the water. Okay. This one is also heat exchange. One gives off heat and other gains energy. Okay. Or the superheater. So this one is heat exchanger. Okay. A regenerator, this is also heat exchanger. You can see there are lots of heat exchangers, mixing chamber. Okay, this one is also a heat exchanger. So the regenerator, this one is used again in power plants. Good, so lots of heat exchangers for the thermodynamic devices. And now let's go back to our questions here. And we have finished one more question. It was this turbine, we have solved it. But this one is a refrigerator cycle. We have solved one part of it, and we have solved the condenser. This is again part of the power plant. Now I have one more example here. This one is a diffuser problem. So it says that we have a refrigerant that enters into diffuser at saturated vapor, 400 kilopascal, and the inlet velocity is 160 meters per second, and the exit pressure and temperature are given. As the refrigerant passes through the diffuser, it gains heat in the rate of 15 kilowatts. Determine the exit velocity, mass flow rate of the refrigerant, if the outlet area of the diffuser is 80% larger than the inlet area. And explain the reason if you have neglected some terms in your calculation. So firstly, let me draw what diffuser looks like. Diffuser is this one. And in this diffuser, the area increases. At inlet, you have area 1. And at outlet, you have area 2. And the refrigerant goes in that way. So we have R134A. It goes in that way, and this is for the same refrigerant, and it leaves the system. Okay. So now the question is, firstly, we should write the energy balance. So for the energy balance, my CV will be the overall diffuser here. So let me write the energy balance for this diffuser. This is the CV. Okay. So for this CV, so you will have that in, which should be the same as out. Okay. So for that in property, you will write that mass flow rate, and the mass flow rate in is same as mass flow rate out. And this is by conservation of mass. And now we will come to energy one, and the energy will be that mass flow rate multiplied with at inlet. You always have, if it is open system, enthalpy at inlet plus that kinetic energy at inlet plus that potential energy at inlet, and plus you have the that it gains. There is also heat transfer Q dot in. So is there work transfer for the diffuser or not? Let me ask this question for you. Is there work transfer for the diffuser or not? So see your comments. Of course, no, there cannot be work transfer. We can see that fluid just flows. Work transfer happens. Okay. So here I can add the work transfer. How we can add it? So you will have that work transfer here. If I put some blades here, or if I put if turbine or rotating shaft. Okay. For example, if I put some, let's say that blades here, you can see that blades. So the flow flows that over it, and it will rotate. As it will rotate, it will have the angular momentum change and the torque and the power. But here that we don't have that case, and therefore that there is no power or work. So now let's write the out properties. Out will be that m dot, enthalpy out, kinetic energy out, and potential energy out. These are the properties, energy balance. So we have to neglect some terms. Okay, it is impossible to solve the problem with a lot of unknowns here with one equation. You have one equation, but lots of unknowns. The first thing is that, let me ask you, which terms are equal? First one, let's get your ideas. Which terms are equal? Mass flow rate, it's of course equal, but energy, which energies are same? Of course, yes, Ali Isayev, potential energy, yes. Potential energy one is same as potential energy two. This is not exactly the same, but it is approximately the same. Now, this term cancel out. And let me ask one more question. Kinetic energy one and the kinetic energy two, which one is higher, one or two? Kinetic energy one is much higher. Therefore, I can put this sign here. Okay, and therefore I can neglect this one to zero. And therefore this goes away. Okay, so you can see that this one is much higher than that one, and therefore I can neglect it. This is the, you know, the diffuser problem, and for the diffuser, so diffuser, so it is used to decrease velocity. If you remember from our previous lecture, to decrease kinetic energy, and but the nozzle here, nozzle is used to increase kinetic energy. Okay, so I've neglected the kinetic energy at point two. Now let me write the values that are given in the question. Q dot in, it is given, which is 50 kilowatts. It will be that 50 times 10 to the power of 3. And the kinetic energy at one is given, which is 160 meters per second. It will be that 160 squared by 2. And the enthalpy at one and the enthalpy at two. I should use the table for find it. Enthalpy at 1, I can find it because it says that it is saturated vapor at 400 kilopascals. So enthalpy at 1 will be at 400 kilopascals. And the X value, what will be the quality for inlet? Let me give your results, your comments. What do you think the quality at inlet is? So X is, this is 1. And Mehmet Tavuk says 1. Okay, you're right. This one is for inlet. And the for outlet, it gives the temperature and the pressure that H2 I should look at 900 kilopascals. Okay. And then 40 degrees Celsius. This one is for outlet. Now I will go to the table for the refrigerant. I will just change the window for presentation. Now I will go to the refrigerant table here. For the refrigerant table. For first one, it is that the value is 400 kilopascal and X is 1. Refrigerant, we have that 400 kilopascal, subtract the refrigerant. 400 kilopascal and X is 1. So I'm looking. So HF value or HG value? Let me ask this question for you. Are we going to take HF value or HG value? So what is your idea? So do we take HF or HG? HG, Mehmet Ağa, Ali, okay. So that HG value will be 255.55. So you will have that HG value 255.55 kilojoules per kilogram. And this one is for table A12. And then you will have that enthalpy at 2, state 2. It says at 900 kilopascals and 40 degrees. And here it is 900 kilopascal and 35 degrees for saturated region. In my case, it is 40 degrees. Which region is this one? Saturated, compressed, or superheated? Okay, Ali says that superheated. Of course, it is superheated. Let's go to the superheated table. And for superheated table, what I will need is that, or that, 900 kilopascals or 0.9 megapascal, 0.9 megapascal, and the temperature is 40 degrees. So you see that 40 degrees and 900 megapascals, 0.9 megapascal. So I need enthalpy value here. Enthalpy value is 274. So this is the enthalpy value, 274.17. Now let me write it. It will be that. 274.17. Okay, and this one is kilojoules per kilogram. And for this one, I have used the table A13. So I have used that table A13. Okay. So therefore, I finished the table part. Now I'm going back to my slides. Okay, so I have the enthalpy at 1, and I'll have the enthalpy at 2, and only unknown is the mass flow rate. Okay, now let's write the mass flow rate equation. Now it will be that, so that, and the Q dot in, which is 15 times 10 to the power of 3, divided by that enthalpy at 1 minus, sorry, it is enthalpy at 2 minus enthalpy at 1. So it will be 274.17 minus will be that 255.55, and this one multiplied with 10 to the power of 3, and this will be the mass flow rate, and this term and that term goes away, and you will have that 15 divided by, and you will have that 2 here and the 6 here, that 8 here and 1 here. Okay. So 15 divided by 18.62. So what is that value for the mass flow rate? If you tell the answer, 0.8. Ali says that it is 0.8. Ahmet Ağa 0.8. Yes, okay. So you have got the 0.81 kilograms per second with this one. So I have found the mass flow rate of the refrigerant. And the exit velocity, it says that determines the exit velocity of the refrigerant and the area change. Now let's do that. Find the exit velocity. This is the, we'll have this diffuser here, and the mass flow rate at inlet is same as mass flow rate at outlet. Okay, and the density, area, and the velocity at inlet is same as density, area, and the velocity at outlet. This is the equation for the mass flow rate. Okay, and then I can, in the question it says that where is that outlet area is 80% larger than inlet area, and outlet area is that area inlet plus 0.8 of area inlet. Okay, and therefore it will be that 1.8 area inlet. So therefore you will have that this area outlet will be 1.8 area inlet, and therefore these two terms cancel out. And the velocity at inlet, it is given in the question. It says that the velocity at inlet is 160 meters per second. And the only unknown values are these densities. And the density at inlet is the same as 1 by nu inlet, the specific volume at inlet. And this specific volume at inlet, I can determine it as 400 kilopascal, and x is 1. Okay. This will be that nu g from the table, and then from that nu g I will find the density. And for the outlet property, that rho out again will be 1 by nu out at, will be that 900 kilopascals, and the temperature is 40 degrees Celsius. Okay, and here I will find the nu value. I will just take the values from the table. It is the same table, and they will use that it again. So you will have that 0.9 megapascals, and for the 40 degrees Celsius, new value from the table is 0.0234. This is the new value, and from here you can tell me that rho out, what is it? And the new G value for the temperature and the 400 kilopascals, that new G value is 0.05. And the 1, 2. This is the nu g value, and you can tell the rho inlet. You can calculate the rho inlet and the rho outlet, and therefore velocity at outlet will be equal to that rho inlet multiplied with velocity inlet and divided by the rho outlet. This will be the final value for the velocity at outlet. And this one is from the same table, and this is from the table A2, let me see this table. A, where is that? A12. Okay, and this one will be the next table, which is A30. Okay, so if you have the values, you can tell me the. So for outlet, it is 42.7. For inlet it is 19.53. This one is kilograms per meter cube, and the kilograms per meter cube. And then velocity will be just this ratios here. Velocity inlet is 160, this one is 160, and the density is, we have found it, 19.53, and outlet is 42.74. Okay, so with this one, we will finish the example, and it is 73 meters per second. Okay. So actually, you can see that we have here neglected the kinetic energy. So there is, this one is not so small with respect to that one. Okay, so therefore, that kinetic energy, if you neglect it, it is not so accurate here. So you can see that we have said that kinetic energy 1 is much greater than kinetic energy 2, but in reality kinetic energy 1 is 2 times kinetic energy 2 approximately. No, it is not 2 times, but it should be that times, four times actually. Yes, it is good. It is good, but it is not so much large, okay, because the velocity is 73, and here you have that 160. It is two times velocity, but four times. But kinetic energy at one, let me write here, kinetic energy at one will be equal to four times kinetic energy at two, approximately. Four times kinetic energy at two. We have taken that kinetic energy one is much greater than kinetic energy. Good. So now let's move on to the next example here. The example is that we have an ideal flow through a constant diameter pipe, and during that flow, some heat is transferred. The values are given below in a table. Determine the values that in question mark. Okay. P inlet is given, temperature inlet is unknown, velocity inlet unknown, P outlet is given, T outlet given, M dot is unknown, rho inlet is given, velocity inlet outlet is given, and diameter pipe, name of the gas, R value is not given, Cp is given, Cv is given, rate of heat transfer into the system is not given, and the density at outlet is given. But this is the question that we should answer. So to solve that equation, firstly, to solve this problem, we have to write all of our equations. So all of our equations. And the first equation is that, for our case, that P inlet, and we will have that. And let me write in that is that PV is MRT. Okay, this is the equation. But since in these questions, the densities are given, you can see where is that density? Yes, densities are given. Therefore, I can write this one as P is M by V into RT, and P is rho RT. Okay, therefore, our equation will be that P inlet will be equal to density at inlet, R, and the temperature at inlet. This is the first equation that I will have. Pressure at outlet will be that density at outlet and R, temperature at outlet. This is my second equation. And my third equation will be that I will have mass flow rate. Okay, that mass flow rate inlet will be same as mass flow rate at outlet. And that one will be that density at inlet, area at inlet, and velocity at inlet will be same as the density at outlet, area at outlet, and the velocity at outlet. This is my next equation. And my last equation will be energy balance. And for the energy balance, the ins and out properties are equal. And here says that during that flow, some heat is transferred. Okay. Is it an in quantity or out quantity? It is not stated here, but okay, let's assume that it is into the system. Okay. But we don't know it, but we will find it as the question goes on. But assuming, so it will be that heat into pipe. If you assume that, you will have that mass flow rate, and then at inlet, you will have that enthalpy inlet and kinetic energy inlet and potential energy inlet plus that Q dot inlet will be equal to that mass flow rate and enthalpy at outlet, kinetic energy at outlet, and potential energy at outlet. These are the equations that we are going to have. We have four equations. Here we have four equations, and we are trying to solve the unknowns here. Now, first, let's simplify our equations. I will start firstly the mass flow rate equations here. For mass flow rate, which terms are same? Okay, one of the terms for the mass flow rate is same. What is that? Yes, areas are same. Area out and area in same, because it says that it is that constant diameter pipe. Yes. Now for the second part of the question, so if you remember, we have said that for all of the problems, most of the problems actually, that excluding the nozzle and the diffuser, okay, except you have the nozzle or you have the diffuser. Okay. Except the nozzle and the diffuser, kinetic energy, potential energy, and they are zero. Change of kinetic energy, change of potential energy is zero. Okay. This one is even true for, so that let me actually not make the problem as confusing. So that kinetic energy is zero. This one is four, except nozzle and diffuser. But generally, that potential energy change is zero. Therefore, I will cancel out that term and this term and that term and this term. Okay. So you have these four equations, and now let's solve it one by one with the given values. So pressure at inlet is given as 12 kilopascals. So this one is 12 times 10 to the power of 3. And the density at inlet, it is given as 5.6. So it will be that 5.6 kilograms per meter squared. And the R value, it is unknown. Temperature at inlet, it is not given. Okay, this is also a question mark. Now let's see the temperature, pressure, and the other values. Pressure at outlet, it is 83 times 10 to the power of 3. And the density at outlet, where is that? Density at outlet. It is given as 3.08 kilograms per meter squared. And the temperature at outlet, it is given as 50 degrees. And 50 degrees, since we are working with ideal gas equation, it should be 273. You should add it. Otherwise, it will be false. And from here, you can find the R value. Okay, you can see that R value can be found. So if you find the if you can find the R value here, you can tell me, and I will just replace it here. It will be y p out is equal to rho r t out. From that equation, we can find it. So can you tell me? So it is by, so that P out is equal to rho R T out. Okay. So yes, everything is okay. So if you find the R value, you will just replace the R value back to here, and then we will find the temperature at inlet. If you know the temperature at inlet, and the rest will be easy. So that 6.362.4. Okay. Okay, now you have found the R value here. Now comes that, since you have found the R value, that we can find now the temperature at inlet. Temperature at inlet, because you know the R value here, and then here the R value is okay, but at the beginning it wasn't known. This one is, at the beginning it was unknown, but now we know it. So after finding R, if you tell me the 5 point temperature at inlet. No, actually, 5.9 Kelvin. Okay, this one is Kelvin, unit is Kelvin. Okay, so we have found the R values and the velocity inlet, and these are all unknown. Now let's find it. We know the density at, let's go back to the equation for the mass flow rate. For mass flow rate equation, we know the density at inlet, where is that? Density at inlet is 5.6, and the velocity at inlet and the outlet. Velocity at inlet is not given, this is under question mark. And velocity at outlet, that is given as 3.2. And the density at outlet, it is given as 3.08. But you should remember that you see the velocity is given. It is not a problem. Except nozzle and the diffuser, we neglect the kinetic energy change and the potential energy change. There can be some, if it is very high velocity, yes, it is considered. But for low velocities, for example, this one, we don't consider it. So, and here you don't have the velocity at inlet, and the velocity at inlet, this one, we can determine it by that conservation of mass. So if you solve this conservation of mass, you have the velocity at inlet, it is 1.76 meters per second. This one is the velocity for inlet. Alice says, okay, so that now comes the mass flow rate. You can see the mass flow rate, it is also unknown. So, but for that mass flow rate, what I will do is that rho area and the velocity. Okay. This one will be that mass flow rate, rho area and the velocity. And I can take any in that is the same as rho area, velocity and out. Doesn't matter whether it is in or out. I will just take the in values here. So in values, I will have that density at inlet is 5.6 multiplied with velocity area is pi squared by 4. You will have that pi into 11 times 10 to the power of negative 2 and squared by 4. And that will multiplied with velocity at inlet. And the velocity at inlet is 1.76 meters per second. And you can solve this problem. So you see that goes one by one. And if you find that one, so this one will be the mass flow rate for the problem. Okay, 0.093 kilograms per second. This is the mass flow rate. Okay, now comes the next equation. We have found the mass flow rate. Next equation is mass flow rate enthalpy in plus Q dot in mass flow rate enthalpy out. Mass flow rate enthalpy in plus that Q dot in will be equal to mass flow rate enthalpy out. This one was we have assumed. Now let's see that if your assumption is true. At the outlet, temperature is 50 degrees Celsius. This one is 50 plus 273. At the inlet, it is 5.9 Kelvin. Okay, so we found that T inlet is, it is given actually, T outlet is 5.9 Kelvin. Okay, and since the outlet temperature is less than the inlet, therefore this one was wrong. Okay. The fluid was given up, so therefore this one is less than T inlet. The Q dot in assumption was wrong. Okay. But anyway, I will not change the equation here, but at the end it will be negative. Negative means that you have to make it positive to be Q dot out. So this one multiplied with enthalpy inlet, okay, and the plus this one is in. And again, 0.093 enthalpy at output. And for ideal gases, if you remember it, for ideal gases, yes, change of enthalpy is Cp into delta T. Similarly here, you will have that Q dot in will be equal to 0.093 multiplied with Cp and multiplied with T out minus T in. And the T out is this one, 5.9 Kelvin, and T inlet is 273 plus 50. It is 323. This one is for inlet. And Cp value, it is given in the question. Cp of the gas is 1.038. It is kilojoules. You should see that unit. So therefore, I should convert into units of joules. Okay. Multiplied with 10 to the power of 3 and divide by. Not to divide by, should be that joules per kilogram degree Celsius, or it can be that joules per kilogram Kelvin, doesn't matter. Okay. From here, you can find the value of the Q dot in, but it will be negative value. And the negative value means that Q dot in assumption was wrong. We have seen it because the temperature outlet is less than temperature at inlet, and the sense is Mamma power. Yes, you have found it 0.09. Or Mammoth power set to 0. It's a 0.094, you can make it, but Mammoth power, yes. Negative, so negative 30610.93. Okay, this one is that joules, or the negative 3.61 kilo joules. It is negative, you can see it. Therefore, that Q dot out will be equal to positive 0.61 kilojoules. So actually it is not kilojoules, sorry, it is watt. It is not kilojoules, these are watt quantities. Okay, it should be watt units. This one is watt, This one is kilowatt and this one is kilowatt. Okay, so with this one, we have finished this problem too. Madat also says, okay. Madat, Mamta Ali. Okay, so you are right, all you have got the same answer. So therefore, no problem with this question. Okay, so we have solved this problem too. Let me see if the next question is taking lots of time or not. And we have a compressor problem here. I have 2 minutes. At the end, I can just write the numbers here and solve it in the next lecture. We have a saturated vapor refrigerant at 60 kilopascals that enters compressor with a mass flow rate 2.5 grams per second. The pressure and the specific volume of refrigerant at outlet is 140 kilopascals and 0.25 meter cubes per kilogram. The work of the compressor is 90 kilojoules per kilogram. Find the transfer heat from or into the compressor in kilojoules per kilogram. So that compressor is, so let me show you the compressor, how it looks like in reality. This is the compressor. You can see the compressor. And this is used, so this can be as small as this one, but it can be at a very large, at size of this one, let me show you. It can be as large as this one, turbine here. Let me show the turbine, like this one. This one is actually, this one is the turbine, but opposite of it, where you have the decreasing, if the flow goes in that direction, it is exactly the compressor. If the flow goes in that direction, it is a turbine, but in that direction, it is the compressor. Okay, so that this is the compressor, and the question has given us some values for the outlet of it here. Some values are given, and also for inlet, some values are given for the compressor. Here you have the, for example, pressure temperature. Here you have the pressure temperature, and the question says that you can find the work of this compressor, how much electricity does it use, or you can find the heat transfer, heat loss of the compressor. How you get those values by the pressure and the temperature? You have the sensors here. You can see the sensor. It gives you the pressure values. And if you have also the temperature sensor, you can get the temperature values for the compressor. Okay, now let me go back to the question here. Okay, so I have the compressor, something like this one. And for that compressor, you have the inlet at 60 kilopascal, and this one is saturated vapor, so X is 1. And then with a mass flow rate is 2.5 grams per second. This is the inlet. The pressure and the specific volume at outlet, you have the outlet too. And for the outlet values, you have that pressure, which is 140 kilopascal pressure at outlet, and the specific volume is, this one is the specific volume, 0.19025 meter cubes per kilogram. And the work of the compressor, it is given in the question that compressor uses work, and this one is 90 kilojoules per kilogram. And find the transferred heat from or into the compressor in kilojoules per kilogram. Okay. So these are the general values that are given, and this one is the out, and this one is the in. Okay. So I think we have finished our time. So I stop the recording here. If you have questions, you can ask. Otherwise,